In the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Carl P. asks us, do women's menstrual cycles really sync up when they live together? The belief that women's menstrual cycles will synchronize if they are in close proximity to one another is widely held. In 1999, one study reported that 80% of women believe this phenomenon occurs, and 70% of them find it pleasant to have this be the case. So, is this actually true? Well, sorry to disappoint, but it doesn't appear so based on the current, rather robust body of research done on this subject. So, well, why do pretty much all women and an awful lot of guys believe this? Well, let's dive in deep, shall we? A woman's menstrual cycle is counted from the first day she begins menstrual bleeding until the first day of the next menstrual bleeding. This cycle can vary from 21 to 35 days, although the average is 28. It is separated into four different phases: the menses, follicular, ovulation, and luteal phases. The menses phase is when the woman is actually bleeding. The average time frame for this bleeding is 3 to 5 days, though 2 to 7 is considered normal. It's this phase people are paying attention to when they talk about menstrual cycles syncing up. They look at the first day of bleeding as the start point. The follicular phase is where the follicles in the ovaries begin to mature and form an egg. Simultaneously, estrogen levels rise, causing the lining of the uterus to thicken. Ovulation then occurs, which releases the egg due to an increase in a hormone called the luteinizing hormone. The final phase is the luteal phase. The egg is released from the ovary and travels down the fallopian tubes and into the uterus. If the egg is fertilized and attaches to the uterine wall, pregnancy begins. If not, estrogen and progesterone levels fall, causing the thickened lining in the uterus to shed, and the menses begin again. The entire process, from the start of menses to the beginning of the next menses, is mediated by hormones. Because of the hormone mediation, proponents of the synchronization theory claim that pheromones can affect hormone levels and thus affect the cycle. This theory began in 1971 when a psychology student at Harvard, that's Martha McClintock, published a paper in Nature stating that women who spend a lot of time together will tend to have their menstrual cycles synchronize over time. She theorized that pheromones affected the hormones of the women, which caused this synchronization. The idea of pheromones affecting people in general is already extremely controversial, and it would take us an entire video to do justice to that, so let's not get into it here. That being said, though, in 1998, McClintock published another paper in Nature which found that if a woman was exposed to cotton pads soaked in the sweat of women in their follicular and luteal phases, the phases of their cycles were significantly altered. The controversy lies in how to interpret the data from McClintock's and others' studies. The different lengths of cycle times and a myriad of other things that affect cycles caused the results to simply be a matter of chance. One researcher, H. Clyde Wilson, outlined three serious errors involved in McClintock's research. And when you correct for these errors, the evidence for synchronization evaporates. Alright, so now you might be wondering, well, why is this so complicated? Well, that's because defining what exactly synchronization in cycles is can be extremely difficult. While there are averages, most women tend to have their own unique cycle that can be affected by many things. Suppose you have one woman who has a 28-day cycle and one that has a 29-day cycle. If they both start menses at the same time this month, they will be off one day on the following cycle and then 2 days on the one after that. Over time, they will once again have a cycle that will coincide with one another. To take it one step further, let's say you have women at both ends of the normal range for cycles. The first has a 21-day cycle and the other has a 35-day cycle. If the woman who has a 35-day cycle starts on January the 1st and the woman with a 21-day cycle starts on January the 15th, both of their cycles will start at approximately the same time the next month. That's February the 4th and February the 5th, respectively. Those two women could say, wow, we were 2 weeks off last month and this month we've been spending a lot of time together, and wow, look, our periods have synchronized. It's amazing. Amazing it might be, but science it is not. Other things to consider when talking about cycle periods is that each individual has different patterns of normal. Some have regular patterns, some have variable patterns, and others have regularly irregular patterns. Those same women can also experience different cycle lengths and regularities depending on several different environmental factors such as strenuous exercise, puberty, and menopause, as well as other things like low body fat, extreme weight loss, extreme weight gain, All of these things have been shown to alter cycle lengths. Due to the fact that hormones regulate the entire process, anything affecting hormone levels will, in turn, affect menstrual cycles. Simply interpreting the data and not being cognizant to our confirmation bias, the tendency to search for or interpret information in a way that confirms one's preconceptions, can lead to errors in statistical analysis. Take, for a specific example, two subjects involved in a study that started on July the 1st. Subject A, with a 28-day cycle, starts her menses on July the 25th, and then again on August the 22nd. Subject B, with a 30-day cycle, has her onset start on July the 5th, and again on August the 4th. If you believed in synchronization theory and were not aware of your confirmation bias, you could look at these numbers and conclude their cycles were 20 days apart, July the 25th and July the 5th in the beginning, and are now 18 days apart at the second onset, August the 4th and August the 22nd. Thus, the subjects are probably synchronizing. The truth is, the opposite is actually true. They are diverging and not converging. Subject A would have had the menses start on June the 27th as well. This is not looked at by this study starting on July the 1st. That puts both subjects' start as 8 days apart in the beginning, June the 27th and July the 5th. The second cycle of July the 25th and August the 4th makes them 10 days apart and diverging. This is the exact opposite of the original conclusion. So you can see from this how it would be easy for a study on this subject, if not performed correctly, to provide very wrong conclusions, even without all the noise of things like regularly irregular periods and other factors affecting hormone levels. The idea that synchronization is simply a matter of chance has been replicated by other studies since McClintock's so-called groundbreaking conclusion in 1971. One of the most famous was done by Zhengwei Yang of North Sichuan Medical College in China and Jeffrey Shank of UC Davis in 2006. They found women living in groups did not synchronize their cycles. They looked at and analyzed previous studies claiming that synchronization had occurred. After correcting for statistical errors, they showed those results were really at just the level of chance. They went on to show that because of cycle variability, they produce convergences and divergences in menses onsets, and this explains the perception of synchrony. In the end, Michael Shermer, in the book Don't Believe Everything You Think, said it best. Smart people believe weird things because they are skilled at defending beliefs they arrived at for non-smart reasons. Whether you believe McClintock and say that your menses converging and diverging as a result of pheromones affecting your hormones, or you take a step back and look at the main body of research that gives a non-pheromone-mediated reason for why the convergences and divergences happen, the result, it's the same. Due to the differences in female cycles and the environmental factors that can affect them, there will inevitably be certain times when the women in your family will all be in their menses phase at the same time. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, give us a thumbs up below. Also, if you're looking for something else to watch right now, why not check out our new channel called Fact Quickie? It's shorter stuff like this. It's hosted by my occasional co-host, Davin. You can find that linked to in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching.